Hello viewers, welcome to my show. Well, as promised, I am back with yet another inspiring story from an amazing personality. He studied to be a medical doctor, but somehow decided that he was going to serve his country and people by joining the IAS. And so he did in 1995, where he joined the Tamil Nadu IAS cadre. And from there on, there has been no looking back. He has a Chevening Gurukul scholar from the London School of Economics and Political Science and an LKY fellow and MPM degree holder from the National University of Singapore and Harvard Kennedy School of Government. And his abiding passion is to transform governance within his jurisdiction with the help of tools and practices from information technology. He has got over 250 innovations under his credit. Oh my God, whom are we talking about? Dr. Santosh Babu. It's such an honor to have you on my show, Dr. Babu.
Absolute pleasure being with you, Dr.
What an amazing, so much of work behind you. So first of all, you tell my audience, Dr. Babu, that what made you join IAS after you studied to be a medical doctor?
Thank you, Dr. Renika. Right from childhood, my father used to say that if you want to serve your country, the IAS is possibly the best option. So at third standard, fourth standard, I think he probably brought the first Competition Success Review magazine.
Okay.
So Competition Success Review, as you know, features the toppers, as it
were.
And the stories, the trials and tribulations that they've gone through too. So that kind of inspired, and then me and my sister were onto it every month.
But then why after medicine? I mean, after MBBS, Trivandrum Medical College is through merit.
Absolutely.
And then
Around 10 lakh to 15 lakh people write the prelim examination. And finally, only 80 people get into the IAS.
Right.
This year, I think around 160 people, these years. During our times, it is only around 80 people who got the IAS. So there's no surety that you'll get into the IAS.
So you
need
a fallback
option.
Fallback option.
Yeah.
But was becoming doctor your passion? Was
absolutely.
There passion?
That was a huge passion. In case I didn't qualify for the IAS, I would have become a very good doctor.
I'm sure.
Least.
I have no doubt. And you married a doctor, an amazing immunohematologist.
She's an immunohematologist and a transfusion medicine expert.
Absolutely. Yeah. But your son decided not to become a doctor.
That's right. He's an engineer.
Yeah. And a state topper.
He's a fourth rank holder in the plus two examination of
wonderful,
the state board.
Wonderful. So impressive.
Thank
Dr. Santosh Babu, you've got so much of work behind you. I mean, like, I remember, you know, you were telling me how dilapidated buildings you've converted into swanky offices, and then those schools, the way you've, converted them into such lovely buildings. And then your predecessors, I think, had a turnover of 35 crores and
31.
Today 31 crores, and you've turned it to a 75 crore
plus
turnover.
This year, touched more than
75 crores. Yeah. Crores. Amazing, amazing. So what, first of all, let's actually talk about your passion to do this. Now, we've seen that you used information technology to kind of innovate and to renovate and to bring all your ideas. And you always think out of the box. So what is this behind this? I mean, what goes on in your mind? How do you think like this?
No, actually, the IAS offer that matter, politics, you know, you have to be a leader. And you are a leader by design, default, or just because you are there. But because you are a leader, a huge audience downstream is looking up to you for that leadership. So if you can communicate a compelling aspiration to your people, they will take care of the rest. You just need to motivate them, give them a big idea.
Right.
Listen to them. So right. I constantly say that, you know, the first letter L would stand for being a good listener.
Right.
So I think I'm a good listener. Whichever office I go, in the first 15 minutes, we have a think tank meeting where from the PUN to the CMD, anybody can speak.
Yeah.
Because if you're for an IAS officer going to a new organization, even the PUN is better than you because they have more domain knowledge than you. You're going to get into a new organization. So better listen to people.
Mm.
And they will come up with huge number of ideas.
Right.
If you give them an audience, they are some of the best people because they know how it is run, how it can be, etc.
In fact, your driver only told you how to make your present
office. That's right,
office.
So the first think tank meeting when I joined in 2014 in Tamil Nadu Handicrafts Development Corporation, this man said, sir, why didn't you do this, and in the building, if you're planning to construct a couple of more floors, we can take our people to the top. They're sitting in a cellar. If we can sell, convert the cellar into a godown,
mm.
where we are paying more money
right.
to the private sector to actually keep it as a godown, etc. So that I thought it was a brilliant idea and convert into a 3.5 crore project. Then I requested money from government. I didn't get it. So immediately we took a loan from NABARD. And now I have a very beautiful office, let me
wow.
tell you. Please come to the Tamil Nadu Handicrafts Development Corporation. It's right behind HDFC Bank on the Mount Road. It's one of the most beautiful offices, government offices you can ever see.
Yes, and my viewers would definitely love to do that. I think, and I hope you're not the typical bureaucrat. It's so difficult to get an appointment. They
Anybody
can just
can
walk
in between 10 and 5:45, I'll be there.
How nice. So, make use of this opportunity. This man is amazing. And the way he's converted an old office into what he's right now sitting in is truly inspirational. Dr. Babu, you have, you know, served the government of Tamil Nadu in various capacities, right from a sub-collector to an executive director of the Tamil Nadu Corporation for Development of Women. I think that is an amazing project. And I think even in Krishnagiri, you have done a lot of, you've got a BPO for the children, dropout, school dropout, urchin kids. Tell us a little about that. What is this for the children and the women that you've been doing?
Actually, my own feeling is that everybody is born equal. That's what people say. But the only difference between you and me and probably the poor is they don't have a circumstance.
Hmm.
So I think everybody's job, including yours, mine, hmm. those in the NGO sector, etc., is to provide that circumstance.
Hmm.
And then you can see their talents blooming.
Right.
So I've seen these young 5th standard, 3rd standard dropouts.
Mm.
When you bring them back to school and give them the right ambience and atmosphere and the inputs, they transform themselves.
Okay.
So we brought back 10,000 out-of-school children in Krishnagiri. It's not a joke. It's a huge, massive exercise.
Wow.
And that's why Dr. Kalam actually called me on telephone and spoke about it. We can actually track every out-of-school child.
Mm.
So if he drops out again, then we'll go back and kind of fall at his feet and come, please come back to school.
They come.
They'll come. You provide, so the only things we used to ask is, what will it take for you to come back to school?
Mm.
Anything under the sun, the collector can provide, because government of Tamil Nadu is one government which provides almost everything free, which can be used for the benefit of the poor.
Mm.
So, right from foot to head, you can provide lots of stuff, which the collector is empowered to do,
mm.
as it were.
Mm.
So, I use that opportunity to bring back all those children. For
mm.
example, around 1,000 government jobs were given for noon meal workers,
Ooh.
Were given to the out-of-school children mother, so that, you know, while they cook at the school, the children will be coming back to school. They won't drop out.
Okay.
So I found that these young boys and girls have an amazing skill in their minds,
mm.
but it requires a circumstance for them to explore their skill and talent. So that's what drives me, actually, because I feel that, you know, we have 1.25 billion people in
yes.
India.
Yes.
And
20, I think more than 50% are under the age of 25.
Yeah, that's right.
There's
a youth,
the
youth population is massive.
Absolutely.
And that's a promise for this country again. And I'm sure in the next 10, 15 years, the whole
demographics
supposedly
to, yeah.
people below poverty line will
come,
go out of that
out.
And go into prosperity.
Thanks to people like you. Wow, truly inspirational, isn't it? So I'm going to now slip into a very short break. And then on return, we're going to talk of these amazing projects that Santosh Babu has done for our society, especially for the children and rural women, and the way he's made a difference in everyone's life. Stay tuned. We're going to return very, very shortly and quickly. I'll see you in a bit.